and God bless you. This is your brother Tally. We're back again this week. Amen. Last week I took a break, a much needed break, but I do feel refreshed. I feel renewed, and I truly do feel ready to go. Amen. I had a very good sleep last night, and praise God for all of the things He does. Amen. One of the videos that I made this past month that caused a little bit of controversy was the self-destruction of Lecrae and Reach Records. But previously to that, I had also made several videos on the occult symbolism that is appearing on way too many Christian albums. Obviously, I understand that the first reaction that anyone is going to have is a defensive reaction. You will be defensive. You will get upset. You will get angry. But all I'm asking of you today is to let's take time to have a dialogue, a brief dialogue, and you hear me out today. You see, in Hebrews 12:28, it says, "Wherefore we receiving a kingdom which cannot be moved, let us have grace, whereby we may serve God acceptably, with reverence and godly fear." With reverence and godly fear. These are important words that God has inspired in His scriptures. And far too many people do not, well, let's just say, they underestimate the capabilities of the devil, the enemy, to infiltrate the things of God. You underestimate that the devil can appear as an angel of light. God did not inspire that in scripture. God did not just warn you in scripture just because He was bored. God consistently tells us in 1 John 4:1, "Beloved, believe not every spirit." Believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Notice how God says many. Many false prophets are gone out into the world. And my apologies if you hear my chihuahua barking or anyone talking. I have a family, right? So I've brought forth to you in the past year for the glory and honor of Jesus Christ, because without Jesus Christ, I am nothing. And the Lord Jesus Christ knows that I am not the only brother who is speaking on this topic. There's a wide variety of brothers and sisters in the Lord that God has brought up to speak out on this topic. For the glory of Jesus Christ, God has even brought up even individuals who are Christian rappers who speak out on this topic. We have mentioned to you how little by little, there's an infiltration happening within what we call quote-unquote Christian music. I showed you how on Skillet Awake's album cover there was a one-eye symbolism. Then we moved on to Toby Mac, Eye on It, where he has the eye right there in front of you. But most crazy about it, he has a song itself called, well, where he actually says, "Illuminati coming through."
Swing like the clay. One day I'ma make the whole world pay. With KOs and okay, we bash class and dot dash. You got that right, I'ma rock the Morse code tonight. Transmitting, throw a fist and paparazzi like Zips. Get flipped out, squeeze fresh like.
like juicy sun kissing. If I miss with my missiles, you're still gonna sizzle, cause I fizzle fry radiation style worldwide.
I showed you about a year ago on Trip Lee's album cover how he has the one eye marked out. And then we also showed you how on Andy Mineo's album cover how it has a skull with one eye. But the crazy part is that as you're seeing a human being on his website, it turns into a one-eyed skull. You also see here on the promotional video on his actual website, here you have additional covers of the Neverland album. Once again, the one eye is standing out right there in front of you. We also have the one eye of Ra on Andy Mineo's album cover as well. So, for some reason, there is an infiltration of occult symbolism happening on a lot of Christian records. One could call it bad decision making, because we all make bad decisions. And another, it could be said that very, very honestly and simply, something is trying to be portrayed and messaged to you via these symbols. You know how God says for us to test the fruits? These symbols are fruits. Fruits of what's coming out of that record label. And we can either decide to ignore those fruits, or we can decide to actually see what's happening and just cordially and kindly examine and test the spirits. In 1 Thessalonians 5:22, it says it clear, abstain from all appearances of evil. And sadly, within the Christian music industry, our brothers and sisters out there in the Christian music industry, they seem to not understand the importance of this very, very verse here, where it says to abstain from all appearances of evil. Since the making of my last video a few weeks ago, a lot of people were upset, and I understand that. It happens. It's normal for you to get upset. As my brother from the Awaken to Truth channel, a great channel for Jesus Christ, says, truth hurts. Lies kill. And that is very, very important truth right there. As this past week happened, and I saw that Trip Lee was coming out with an album, when I saw the physical album cover of his album, I immediately felt conviction within my spirit, and I felt something pointing me in this direction. And I know I may sound crazy with what I'm bringing up to you, but it's just too much for me to simply ignore. You see, this is beyond the iffies. Like, for example, in Lecrae's Broken featuring Carrie Jobe, where he has an X over one where his eye is supposed to be. That's an iffy. Or in that same video where he has his two eyes looking at the screen and all of a sudden they block out one eye so it only shows one eye. That's an iffy. That's an assumption. It's not like when you go to Andy Mineo's video and you see bluntly the eye. Or you go to Awake Skillet and you see bluntly the eye. Or you see Trip Lee's bluntly crossing out one eye. And so forth. what came out on Trip Lee's physical cover is a rising phoenix. A rising phoenix. The album itself is called Rise. Let me give you a little bit of information regarding the phoenix. And there's brothers and sisters that can do this in 20,000 ways better than I can. But I want to give you a little bit of information on it. The phoenix bird is one of the oldest occult symbols in the world, having been invented in the Egyptian satanic mysteries. Occultists believe that only one of these majestic birds lives at any one time, and lives to be about 500 years old. Then it self-immolates and its body is reduced to ashes. However, a new phoenix bird immediately arises out of these ashes to live another 500 years. This was Manly P. Hall in The Phoenix, an illustrated review of occultism and philosophy as quoted by Dr. Burns, Masonic and Occult Symbolism, illustrated page 121. The phoenix that we see today arises from a bird called the Bennu bird, and you're seeing it on the screen. You've been seeing it for the past 30, 40 seconds or so. The Bennu bird, as you can see on the bottom pictures, resembles like a huge heron. Okay? It had two long feathers on the crest of its head and was often crowned with an Atef crown of Osiris. The Bennu bird, if you study what the Bennu bird was, the phoenix, it was associated with the sun, and it basically represented the soul of the sun god. In certain periods of time, the hieroglyph of the bird was used to represent the deity directly. So, the rising phoenix is the rising sun god. When Nimrod died in Genesis 10 and 11, for example, just to give you a brief history of Nimrod. Nimrod is that man who led a rebellion against God and built that tower against the commandments and instructions of God, okay? When you study secular history on this individual, you'll know that he was, according to history, cut up into 14 pieces, I believe. And when they found his pieces of bodies, they found all of the pieces except one. And that piece was the obelisk, his male reproductive organ. So they made an obelisk in the image and in the honor of Nimrod, the sun god, because they said that he arose to the sun. Male reproductive organ. And you find this same symbol in front of the Catholic Church. You find it on Washington, D.C., and you find it in world governments all around. You even see the obelisk on top of some churches even. Interesting. Sun worship is something that the scriptures completely destroy, and the scriptures are always speaking out against. Look at what God says about sun worship in Ezekiel 8:16, so that you can see and not be surprised that it's happening now, because it happened then and there's nothing new under the sun. Ezekiel 8:16, and he brought me into the inner court of the Lord's house, and behold, at the door of the temple of the Lord, between the porch and the altar, were about 25 men with their backs towards the temple of the Lord and their faces towards the east, and they worshiped the sun towards the east. Sun worship was very prevalent in those times, and sun worship is very prevalent in today's churches. There is a lot of pastors that are Masons. And there's a lot of ministers and preachers and teachers and singers that you don't know about that have no problem attending a Masonic lodge. This doesn't necessarily make them quote-unquote Illuminati, which is an overused word in my opinion, but this does let you know that they are worshiping the devil without even knowing it. Because when you can go into a Masonic lodge and deny Jesus Christ by calling him the great grand architect of the universe, the Geotsu, as some of them call him, you are crazy. You're absolutely crazy and you're messing with fire. And you can clearly see that there is an Masonic influence. That there is a Luciferian influence coming about in a lot of Christian albums. No longer is this a conspiracy, this is a fact. Before we talk more about Trip Lee's Rising Phoenix, let's look more about the Rising Phoenix. Here in this picture, you have at the bottom, you have two different cathedrals that have the Rising Phoenix, and it looks like an eagle. But it's the Rising Phoenix. You also have on the top left the Rosicrucians, the Jesuits. All of them use the same symbol at times, the Rising Phoenix, which we mentioned symbolizes the soul of the sun god. Lucifer is going to rise out of the ashes, according to some of these people, and he's going to ascend back into heaven. That is a lie and a deception. Here you have Kanye, who also has the symbol, a little emblem thing on his shirt. The double-headed eagle, which is another symbol for the Rising Phoenix. Smirnoff, the Rising Phoenix. And that picture below is from an actual website of a Masonic lodge that has the Rising Phoenix coming out of the ashes as well. On the right, you see different bands. You have the Grateful Dead with the Rising Phoenix. You have Boyz II Fire with the Rising Phoenix. You have Gene Clark with the Rising Phoenix. Here we have a band called Behemoth. And Behemoth also has a double-headed eagle, which is known in that culture of, which is known as the Phoenix. And just for proof of that, look what it says. Behemoth Phoenix, white Behemoth shirt. So artists, secular artists, have no problem selling this. They have no problem showing the fruit of who they are of. Harry Potter. It has Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. And you have the Phoenix rising up out of where? The ashes. Rising up out of hell. Here we have the Legend of Zelda. In the game Zelda, you have the Phoenix behind it. In the game of Zelda, you also have another picture here of the Phoenix behind it as well. And the pyramid on top of it. On X-Men, you have what? The Rising Phoenix. It's subtly placed in different places, you see? Even on an Iron Chef commercial, what do you have behind Iron Chef? The Rising Phoenix. And it says Redemption on the ad as well. It doesn't just stop on video games. It doesn't just stop in movies. It doesn't just stop on different places like Assassin's Creed Rising Phoenix. It's also in comedic blasphemy type of stuff, because you see the devil via comedy does horrible blasphemies against God. Thus we have Tenacious D, and Tenacious D has an album called Rise of the Phoenix.
The pick of destiny was released, it was a bomb. And all the critics said that the deal was done. The sun had set and the chapter had closed. But one thing no one thought about was the deer would rise again, just like the phoenix.
We have the artist earlier that we mentioned, Kanye, wearing his front of his shirt. He has the double-headed eagle, which is the phoenix. He has it there boastly about it. Well, Kanye also made an album called Runaway. And in the album called Runaway, we see the phoenix falling from heaven, which is Lucifer falling from heaven. He takes the phoenix. He starts rescuing the phoenix. He starts singing to the phoenix, mending the wings of the phoenix. An interesting thing happens on that full movie Runaway, the clean version I watched. That you see him looking outside of his window at one point, and you have three characters. You have the Lamb of Christ. You have the phoenix, which is Lucifer. And then you have a deer, which symbolizes innocence to a lot of people. And you'll notice in the movie that he has a choice. But as time progresses in the movie and he fellowships and hangs out more with the phoenix, that as he's looking outside of the window, innocence is no longer there. The deer is gone. No, he has a choice. The Lamb of Christ or the Luciferian Phoenix. And isn't it crazy how the devil has no problem appearing as a man or a woman? Isn't it sick? At the end of the movie, you'll notice how he and the bird have a crazy conversation of how the phoenix is going to burn. And Kanye says to the phoenix, I'll never let you burn.
Your world, anything that is different, you try to change. You try to tear it down. You rip the wings off the phoenix and they turn to stone. And if I don't burn, I will turn to stone.
What do you mean, burn?
If I don't burn, I can't go back to my world.
I don't want you to go back to your world. I want you to stay here with me.
I have to burn.
No. I'll never let you burn.
I have to burn.
No. I'll never let you burn.
I have to burn.
No. I'll never let you burn.
I have to burn.
No. I'll never let you down for the
And then we see how the phoenix now rises up to the heavens. Satan will never rise up to the heavens. Satan is defeated by the blood of Jesus Christ. Then we have also that transgender, Conchita Wurst, who made a song called Rise Like a Phoenix.
Once I'm reborn.
And then we have in the Olympics as well, the rising like the phoenix. It is everywhere you look if you want to look for it. But the least place where you would expect it would be on a Christian album. My hope is that once you see this that I'm going to show you, which you've seen it already, but you might have not been looking for it, that you'll go to Tripley's Facebook and Twitter. That you'll go to Reach Records, Lecrae, and say, Lecrae, what is up with your graphic designer? What is up with your graphic designer? We saw earlier that musicians that are metallic musicians, bands, they sell the shirts of the Phoenix, right? Well, no exception on a Christian record label either. Here you have Trip Lee Rise Phoenix sweatshirt. Because a lot of you are going to type in the comments, tell he's saying rise up in Jesus. Well, not here. He's not saying rise Jesus. He is saying Triple E Rise Phoenix sweatshirt. And they're selling it to you for $33.74. On top, you also have the different shirt styles. One of them says rise. The other one has the phoenix in front of it. And the other one has the phoenix rising as well. Below, we also have another area of the album cover where you see the rising phoenix rising up to the sun. You see the sun around it, and you see once again Triple E Rise Phoenix t-shirt. To some of you, this is shocking, and to others of you, you're so defensive of it that you're still living on I don't know where, and you're saying to yourself, oh, Tally, this is conspiracy. Well, I don't think it's conspiracy when you see it on his website that it says Rise Phoenix. But let's look further. Here you have a comparison of the Boy Sets Fire album, Tomorrow Come Today. And look at the Phoenix shirt. You have the Phoenix on one end and the Phoenix on the other. And you have the Sun Halo on one and you have it on the other. Here you have an even clearer picture. The Phoenix rising up to the sun. That is the sun god. That is Satan himself. Listen, here's what I want you to do with this information that I have shared with you today. I want you to pray about it. Okay? No one at any point in time has name-called anyone. I have not name-called anyone. I have not insulted anyone. So you insulting me does not mean anything to me. Because I've not insulted you. I've come to you with respect and dignity. But I have come to you today showing you and demonstrating to you that at the very best, Reach Records needs to rehire their graphic designer. Because on Andy Mineo's website, he has a regular human turning into a one-eyed man with a skull. And on Andy Mineo's record, he also has the Eye of Ra. And on Triple's record, you have the Rising Phoenix. And there's many more examples, trust me. I'll end with these questions for you. And these questions we should apply to our lives directly as well. James 3:1-12. Doth a fountain set forth at the same place sweet water and bitter? Can the fig tree, my brethren, bear olive berries? Either a vine figs? So can no fountain both yield salt water and fresh. As believers, we need to go back. If you're a musician watching this, if you are a person who sings for God watching this, we need to go back to what worked. And what worked and what delivered people and what set the captives free. is number one, the Word of God, Jesus Christ. But as brothers and sisters in the Lord on this earth representing Him, one of the most beautiful preachings that we can provide to this earth is living an acceptable life before the Lord with reverence and godly fear. Heavenly Father, we come before your presence today asking of you to convict our hearts in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we ask for you to reveal to our hearts if we are listening to certain music because it satisfies our flesh, or if because we're doing it because we truly want to worship you, Lord. Heavenly Father, I pray for Triple E. I pray for Reach Records. I pray for every other individual who claims to be an artist for Jesus Christ. I pray in the name of Jesus for godly conviction. That at the very best, that they have a conversation with their graphic designer and fire him immediately. And at the very worst, if what we are seeing in these album covers are simply the fruits of the artist. Because one would think that yes, they do have to sign off on the concept. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for conviction upon their hearts, Lord. We have young kids bobbing their head to this music, Lord. Not understanding how the devil has used hip-hop to destroy the minority community, Lord. The enemy has used hip-hop to destroy values, morals, and cultures of many of our brethren who are of darker skin color, because we're all of the same color. We just have different shades of melanin. While in the lighter skin community, in the white community, if you will, because I know some may not understand the terms. While the light-skinned community has NSYNC and Backstreet Boys, the darker-skinned community has to have the Wu-Tang, the NWA, the Capone and Noriega Blood Money song, which I used to love, and I rebuke that and I repent of that in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, bring convictions upon the hearts of your brothers. Bring convictions upon the hearts of your sons and daughters all over this world. You have young kids thinking that they're thugs by listening to this Christian hip-hop, bobbing their heads left and right and never even seen a gun in their life. The closest thing they ever come to thug life is Call of Duty. Jesus Christ, bring convictions upon our heart, Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. And God bless you all. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.